Hi everyone, my name is Daniel Sessa and I have your latest home prices and insights for Peel and Durham for week ending December 8th. Now don't worry too much, my dad will be back next week, but for now, you guys are stuck with me. So, I want to talk to you guys about one of the most frequently asked questions we get as realtors, and that is, where are the hottest places to be buying and selling right now? Now we sell homes all across the GTA, most recently selling a beautiful detached home in Brampton last week. And we can tell you with confidence that the demand in Peel and Durham make them two of the hottest, most competitive markets to be in right now. Let's get into the numbers so you guys can see it for yourself. If you want to talk to us about anything related to real estate, we've made it really easy to do that. In the description below, you'll see a link to a calendar. Click on that link, schedule a time that works best for you, and we'll make sure that we're free at that time so we can discuss whatever you want to talk about real estate related. Let's get into the numbers. So this chart shows a breakdown of the three different areas we're going to be talking about. Blue is Mississauga, orange is Brampton, and red is Durham. Durham consists of Ajax, Pickering, and Whitby. Average sold price for Mississauga detached is sitting at $1,918,000. It's a massive jump from the week previous, which was $1,701,000. But what could account for that is the fact that we only sold 45 properties and 10 of them were sold for over $2 million. That means that obviously the gap between prices last year versus prices this year is much higher. We're sitting at 42% over what we did last year, but keep in mind again that we did sell double the amount of homes at $2 million or more. Sold at list price or more. Now we got to start to understand the competition here. 71% of these properties sold at list price or more. Last year that number was only 38. We can see that sales are very similar to what they were last year. And sales have, but they've generally been lower than what they've been last year for the past few months. New listings, again, kind of similar to what they were last year, not too different. Active listings is sitting at 117, and months of inventory. So we're looking at just over 2 weeks of inventory, 0.6, not even a month of inventory in the Mississauga detached market. The average days on market is sitting at 16. A lot of those, I've said it in the video yesterday, this is a fabricated number, the average days on market, because a lot of those could be sold a lot quicker, second, third, fourth day. But because people hold back offers, they're extending the amount of time before they sell the home. So looking at Brampton, Brampton is a bit of a special story here. So we had 72 sales last week and seven of them sold over $2 million. The average sold price currently sits at a record for what we have here in the past year, and I'm assuming a record for going even further back, currently sitting at $1,437 for a detached home in Brampton. Now, one thing we can see here, and I think this is, out of all the reports that we do, this is one of the larger gaps that seems to be widening for the city of Brampton for year-over-year pricing. We are up 44% from where we were pricing last year, and we sold seven more. We actually sold zero homes at $2 million or more in Brampton last year at this time, and this year we sold seven, but we are up 44% this week from prices last year. But you can see it's consistently been above 30 for quite some time now, 30%. Now sold at list price or more. When I tell you that Brampton, Peel is one of the most competitive markets, this right here proves it. 92% of homes are selling at list price or more. Nine out of 10 homes are selling at list price or more. Last year, this number was only 52, which is still a lot higher than a lot of the other regions that had last year. They had lower percentages. 52 is still pretty competitive for Brampton. So it's been competitive for a pretty long time now. Sales, we can see we're on pace to do roughly the same as what we did last year, but we have had a noticeable drop in sales this entire year versus last year. New listings is interesting. We're currently sitting at 121 active listings. This is as of the time we made this chart. We can see that listings have been pretty substantially lower than what they were last year, but we did see an increase in listings this past week versus what we did last year, and a sizable increase from what we did the week prior. So it'd be interesting to see if that continues. Months of inventory, 0.4 months of inventory, less than 2 weeks of inventory in Brampton. Things are very, very tight. One thing I did want to mention is that, you know, I said average days on market is a bit of a fabricated number because of the offer dates. But one thing you'll see in most of the other regions is that the average days on market usually sits around between 8 to 14. A lot of times it's in the double digits. We can see here that Brampton has consistently had average days on market in the single digits. And now what does that mean? That means that yes, there are still offer presentations, but a lot of these properties are getting preemptive offers, and these offers are happening a lot sooner than the offer date they're supposed to have. And we saw that. We saw that personally last week. We had a lot of preemptive offers come in. There's a lot of demand in Brampton right now. Ajax, Pickering, and Whitby. We've seen for the past couple weeks, prices have been dropping for a bit. We're currently sitting at an average price of $1,177,000. Last week, we sold 53 homes. One of them was sold at $2 million or more. Average sales price year over year, we're currently up 20% from last year. We actually did sell an extra home last year that was over $2 million. This year, we only sold one. This week last year, we did sell two. Sold at list price or more. Again, we have another one, you know, 91%. 9 out of 10 homes are selling at list price or more. Just over 9 out of 10 homes. Super, super, super competitive. Last year, we had 62% selling over at list price or more. Again, last year was very, very competitive in Durham. And sales, we see, again, we're close to what we were last year, but it has been dropping since September here that we have on the charts. Listings has gone way down. So the week prior, we had 63 new listings. This week, we only have 44. There's only 72 active listings at the time of making this for Ajax, Pickering, and Whitby detached market. So it's very tight there. And again, that means months of inventory is going to be super, super low. So 0.3 months of inventory, that's like, I think, 10 days of inventory. Average days on market, again, you know, if we're seeing them in the double digits, you can assume that a lot of these homes are being sold with preemptive offers, pushing offer dates closer, because that's just the level of competition. People are submitting bully offers, and then agents want to pull those dates back because they have a good offer in front of them and they want to see what else everyone else brings to the table. So you see average days on market low, you know that there's a lot of preemptive offers coming in, which means a lot of people are trying to get these houses. And the summary for Peel and Durham, Mississauga, months of inventory went up, but it went up to 0.6. I don't think it went up that much. It doesn't mean you're not competing for homes now. Again, same with Brampton. It went up to 0.4. It's still less than 2 weeks of inventory. Competition is not diminished. It's still there. And Ajax, Pickering, and Whitby, Durham, they stayed the same at 0.3 months of inventory. So thank you guys for watching this video. We'll be back next week. Have a good one.